Hello students, today in this session of grammar we are going to start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 7, adverbs. Now, what are adverbs? Now, we have learned about adjectives.
Yes.
We have learned about verbs.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
So, adverbs are the word that modifies. That modifies verbs and
adjectives.
Okay, that modifies what?
Verb
and adjectives. Now, for example, soft. Right, I'm just giving example. Softly. So, by adding ly, we have modified it.
Yes.
Right? Yes or no? So this is what modification of the word, that is adverb. Okay, for example, beautiful, what will come?
Beautiful,
that is, beautiful is adjective, right? So that we can, if you want to change into adverb, how we will write?
Beautifully,
right? Don't get confused in degree of comparison and adverb. Right, degree of comparison is more and most. This is not adjective, this is adverb. It means you have to add ly or you have to modify the word, you have to change the word. Okay, now adverbs are of many types. So we are going to learn about the types of adverbs. So let us start with types of adverbs. Okay. Now, first one, adverb of manner. Now, what do you understand by the word manner?
What
manner or how the action has been done. It shows what? How? The things happened or how the action has been done. Okay, so it gives the answer of what?
How.
Okay, so that is what? Manner. This much is clear, what is adverb of manner? Now for example, he finished his work quickly. Now this sentence gives you the answer that how he finished the work?
Yes.
Quickly. Right. So this is what? Adverb of
manner.
Okay, this example you can write in page number 52. See, in page number 52, question number A. Types of adverb is given. In that sentences, there is a blank in the sentences box, right?
Yes.
There you can write this example. He finished his work quickly. Okay, so this much is clear. What is adverb of manner?
Yes.
Very good. What it will show? It will show how the things happened. Okay, so manner is equal to how. What you will remember? Manner is equal to
how.
Okay. Now next is adverb of place. Now place, it means what you will, what you idea you will get?
Where
the things happen. Inside, outside, downstairs, upstairs. This all suggests what? This all suggests that particular place. Right? It suggests what? Particular place. For example, outside. See, the students are playing outside. So, where the students are playing?
Outside.
Where? It gives the question, it gives the answer of where. Okay? Just for example, Ravi went downstairs with his friend. Where he went?
Downstairs.
What it shows?
Place.
This much is clear?
Yes.
This much is clear? So place is equal to what?
Where.
Okay, what about manner?
How.
Place?
Where.
Okay, this much is clear, student. Adverb of time. Time it will suggest what?
When.
What answer it will give?
When
the action happened or when the things happened. When? Yesterday, today, tomorrow, right? Whatever, this words suggest that when the things happened. Okay? Just for example, I will be late today. So this word today suggests that when you will be late today. Right? So time is equal to when. It gives the answer that when the things is going to be happened or when the things happen. Right? So this is what adverb of time. This much is clear?
Yes.
Manner, place and time. Now we will learn about adverb of degree. Are you writing in your textbook? The examples are you writing?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you have to listen this carefully. Okay, it's not hard, but you have to remember. Right, it's not difficult, but manner, place and time is very easy. Compared to this, here you have to use a little brain. Right, here, degree, it shows the, we can say that intensity or extent. That up to what extent the thing is done. Or up to what extent the thing is, we can say the action is done. For example, I work very hard for the exam. So it shows the intensity of my hard work. It shows the intensity of my hard work that I work very hard. So this word very suggests that this is the adverb of degree. Okay. Why? Because it suggests how often. It tells us how often she is busy on phone, right? Okay, now last one, adverb of
interrogative.
Interrogative, you know what is interrogative?
Question.
So it will be easy or difficult for you?
Very easy.
Are used to ask a
question.
Okay, so adverb of interrogative used to ask a question. In that why, who, right, when, this all things W can come or H can also come, that is how, right? So when did you last meet them? When did you last meet them? Now from this sentence, it is very clear that this sentence is a question. We are asking a question because question mark is also there at the end. So this word suggests that we are asking a
question.
So that will be adverb of
interrogative.
Now students, we are going to start with a simple exercise that is given in your textbook. Question number B. Match the column to form adverb. Right, they have given some words, you have to match it to form adverb. Okay, first one, mean is given.
While.
Meanwhile, or you can also write meantime. Meantime I was away, right? That also you can write. So meantime or meanwhile also you can write. Okay, now second word. Here you can write while, worthwhile. Right? What? Why? Now, next, where? Where?
Yes.
Wherever. Very good. Wherever. Then, four. Under?
Ground.
So easy. Under? Ground. Proper grammatical way, right? So let's start with the position of adverb. Now students, new topic is adverb of position. Now we have already learned about the types of adverb. In that way we have to divide the position, right? For example, if it is adverb of manner, time and place. If it is adverb of
manner, time and place,
where the adverb will be? The adverb will be after the verb, that is after the action. You know the action verbs?
Yes.
Right? So after the action, the adverb will be there. For example, she ate hurriedly. So here, ate is what?
Action.
Action. So after that hurriedly word is there. That is what? That is our adverb. So if it is manner, so she ate hurriedly is a manner. Or time or place, tell me.
Manner.
It is manner, right? Right? So it will come after the verb. Clear? After the verb. What you will remember?
After
verb. After action. Right? Now, if action is not, if it is action is not given, then it can come after the object also. You know what is object?
Yes.
For example, I am work for my friend. Right? So I is a subject. I am performing action. Right? So that will be subject. Right? But who will be the object?
Friend.
Friend will receive. So here object. After object also the verb, adverb can be placed. For example, I met my grandfather yesterday. So it is which type of adverb? First of all, tell me. Yesterday is a time, right? Yesterday. Now listen, I is action. So I will be
subject.
What will be the object in this sentence? Grandfather, right? So it is after object. Right, so that also you have to remember. It can be after verb, it can be after
object.
Right, it can be after a verb or it can be after a
object.
This much is clear to you?
Yes.
Right, now next is verb complement. It can be after verb complement also. Here example is given. For example, we plan to finish the work quickly. Here complement means what? It, you will done it fast, right? For example, in this example, you can see that we have planned to do it the work quickly, right? So that will be verb complement. This will not rarely come, but these two are important. Okay, verb complement will rarely come, but these two are important. Now next, this frequency you have to listen carefully because this is very simple. After the action and after the object. But this is very, very important. Frequency. Frequency, you know what is frequency. What is frequency? How often the things has been done. Now frequency will be between the subject and the verb. Between the subject and the verb. Just for example, I always paint on weekends. Now, I is what?
Object.
Paint is what?
Verb.
Between that, what is there?
Always.
But what is frequency? Adverb, right? So, it will be between subject and verb. That is frequency. When it is frequency, it means you have to remember that when it is frequency, you have to position, means the position should be between the subject and the verb. If it is manner, place and time, it should be after the action or after the object. This you have to fix in your mind. Right? Here, between the subject and the verb. Now, if helping verbs are given, you know na, some verbs are helping verbs like is, then am, are, right? Was, were. If helping verbs are given, then you can place adverb after helping verb also. For example, I am quiet. So, I am. Am is what?
Helping
verb. So, after helping verb also, you can put adverb. Okay? This is clear? Now, listen this carefully. If it is frequency is there in the sentence, if have to and used to, words are given. Have to. Can you see this have to? With have, to is given. Or with used, to is given. Then, before that, adverb will be there. Rarely. Right? So, these are the things that you need to remember. Okay? This much is clear to you, everyone. Okay? Now, next point, two or more adverbs. Now in some sentence there are two or more adverbs, right? It is very easy to identify the adverbs because now you can identify the adverbs, right? So in some sentence there can be two or more adverbs. For example, she performed well here yesterday. Well here. Here suggests what?
Place.
Yesterday suggests what?
Time.
Two or more adverbs. Clear? Right? Now next, adverb that modifies adjective and other adverbs. Now listen, sometimes it modifies the what adjective or it shows the degree, right? So it will come before the adjective. Adjectives you know, right? describing words. So before describing words, there will be what? There will be adverb. For example, the dress is very beautiful. So here beautiful is what?
Adjective.
And what about very?
Adverb.
Simple? Okay. Now, when enough is used as an adverb, it always comes after the word it modifies. Right? For example, did you try hard enough? Hard enough, it means it suggests the, it modifies it. For example, I'll write this on blackboard so it will be more clear for you. Now listen carefully. Did you try hard enough? Now enough is also what? Adverb. Right? Right? So when it modifies the word hard, right? Hard, then it will become after that modified verb. Hard is what? Verb? Hard is what? Verb?
Adverb.
What is hard? Tell me. Right? So it modifies it. It's already adverb, but it modifies it, right? So with the word enough, so it will become after that modification of verb. Okay? This is also rarely, it will come rarely, but other things are important. This much is clear in the position of adverb?
Yes.
Everyone? Okay, fine. Next exercise, pick the best option. Three sentences are given. From that, you have to select the correct order, correct position of adverb. Okay, first one. She used seldom to skip food. She used to seldom skip food. She seldom used to skip food. Now, listen the word I have explained you. Have to and used to. If used to and have to is there, then the adverb will be
before.
So here which one will be right?
C.
Very good. So first one is C. So you just put a tick on C. Now second, it extremely is hot. It is extremely hot. It is hot extremely.
It is extremely
hot. It is extremely hot after the helping verb. Okay, it is extremely hot. Very good. Now third one. He sang well yesterday. He yesterday sang well. He sang yesterday well.
He sang well yesterday.
He sang well yesterday. Very good. This much is clear now. Position is clear to you, right? Now fourth one. I have seen often rainbows. I have often seen rainbows. I often have seen rainbows.
I have often seen rainbows.
Very good. I have often seen rainbows. Now, fifth one. She is sure to perform brilliantly. Brilliantly she is sure to perform. Sure is she to perform brilliantly. Very good. Perform brilliantly. Clear? Sixth one. I have always to get up early. I have to always get up early. I always have to get up early.
I always have to.
Very good. So I always have to get up early. Now next. Seven. I am quite sleepy tonight. Tonight quite sleepy I am. I am tonight quite sleepy.
I am
quite sleepy tonight. Very good. Now others are other means A. Now students, we will start with exercise B, that is replace the underlined ground of word with adverbs. Right? The underlined word we have to change it into adverb. Right? Use the word given in the help box. Help box is already given. Right? So from that you can easily find the adverbs. Right? Question number B. Page number
57.
Okay. Now first one. She ate in silence. Now which word suggests from bracket? Which word suggests silence?
Quietly.
Right. So what we will write?
Quietly.
Now, second, I went to that place.
There.
I went
there.
Right? Very good. Simple or not? Adverbs are simple.
Yes.
Now next, I was born at this place.
Here.
He ate in a very hungry manner. Now you will be confused. What?
Ravenously.
Yes, ravenously. Ravenously means in a very hungry manner. Right? Because now in recess, Keval is going to eat like that only because Keval is very hungry. Right, Keval? Right? So what will be the answer? Now next is very easy. We have examination every year.
Annually.
Very good. I have come and visit you before long.
Soon.
Next is very easy. Mayur will answer. The man glared at me in an angry manner.
Angrily.
Very good. Angrily. Now, who will answer? Once upon a time, armies camped in the fort. Once upon a time. For that, one adverb you can use. Once upon a time. Yes, Niyati? Formally. We can use once upon a time. Now, the quantity of food was just right for all of us.
Enough.
Now, Om will answer. This is easy, so Om will answer. He answered the question in a rude manner. He answered the question in a rude manner. Say, in a rude manner, fast.